Yo, what is good, guys? This is the Poketechnician back here bringing you another video. Today we are featuring the same Inteleon featured mon video that we brought you the last two episodes, but we are finishing it up strong this way, going into series 10. So last video I asked you guys what mon you wanted to be featured next time in our videos, and CloverBells, aka Joe Asad, responded with a really good answer, I thought, talking about how Mimikyu and Mienshao can also use the fling attack to really fling those berries at certain Pokemon and boost their abilities in terms of attacking prowess. Right here, I think we're looking at a sand team, obviously. This is going to be hard. This looks like it's almost like a singles team, but anyhow, we're going to go Inteleon and Raichu. And in the back, we will bring Metagross. And I think Moongus or Faramosa. I think Faramosa is actually a pretty good bet, if we can wait out the sand. So anyhow, I was saying, CloverBells Joe Asad said that you can use mons like Mienshao and Mimikyu to fling into your ally mons and activate their weakness policies, all kinds of cool stuff. And I've used Mimikyu in the past for TR, but I think this time I want to use Mienshao. So I do plan on bringing you guys a Mienshao fling video soon here as well. Just a little fun playoff of this video, basically. So hopefully you enjoy that. In the meantime, we see a sandstorm kick up. We're gonna Dynamax. And I think we can go for just a big G-Max Hydro Snipe as we go for the Fake Out into the Excadrill. Plan on him maxing his T-Tar here. And if I am incorrect, this is gonna make for a very, very poor video. But it's only game one, so. See, as our Inteleon maxes up, I think we lost some tierage due to a new season starting, but we're still somewhere in mid Great Ball tier. I think it's at 7, so. The climb to Master Ball is not all gone at this point. I am worried that if he hits me with that T-Tar, it's just gonna kill my Inteleon. But he does max the T-Tar, so that's good for us. Unless he protects the Excadrill. If he does protect the Excadrill, that's a very, very good play on his part. Now, we do get the Fake Out off. So this Hydro Snipe gonna do really good damage. Gonna take it out, easily. No doubt about it, in my mind. Yeah, takes it out, bam. Good job, Inteleon. Lose a little bit of HP. I have to imagine he's quaking into the Raichu slot. Yeah, quakes into the Raichu slot, that's totally fine. He is gonna get a special defense boost, which is not so great. However, gonna lose a little more HP to that. Faramosa can't come in. Get off a big close combat. It's got the Focus Sash, not gonna matter in the Sandstorm, however. Yeah, now we can't stop the, okay. So what we're gonna do here is go for the Max Hailstorm. And we're gonna go for, I think, the close combat into, those targets attack stat. They're both super effective. So what we have to do here is, since we both outspeed it, I have to double into this. He'll probably go for the max guard, unfortunately. And if he does make that play, or he could be AV. Oh, close combat just takes it out. Oh, wow. Wow, wow, wow. I did not expect that. Okay, cool. So close combat just okos it. That leaves me in a pretty decent situation. Man, I did not expect that. If I had expected that, I would have gone for the Max Hailstorm. Unfortunately, I'm gonna go for the not very effective Hydro Snipe, which crits. Is that crit? No. Okay, I just, man, that's crazy. That does insane damage. Wow, man. Maybe it's Scrubsville right now, but I mean, yeah, I can't imagine how that Hydro Snipe O-code Zapdos, but all right, I'll take it. Bring it on, bring it on. This is, this is game one redemption right here. All right. What is this, the 3-0? Yeah. Oh, battle's canceled, yeah. Okay, cool, so game one, we get a win there. Gonna continue boosting our ranking as we move into series 10. I'm sure it'll get a, I'm assuming it gets a full reset then, maybe not, but. Let's see, nope, don't wanna peep that team. That was a pretty easy win for us, so. Yeah, like I said, big shout out to CloverBells for commenting on my last video. I really appreciate that. And I think it really gave me some good material to think of new teams. Because I like to use that heat stuff, especially like mienshao. Mienshao is super frail, so you can use a good support of mienshao. Mienshao had some tricks in its bag I didn't realize, so definitely excited to bring that for you guys. Let's see. Got rain team.deck here. Rain team.deck says Raichu. I wish Metagross had Thunder Punch right now for sure. Feramosa, what are you doing? Not a lot. Inteleon, also virtually useless. I think it's Raichu Metagross or Raichu Togekiss. I think it's Raichu Togekiss for sure. We'll go Metagross and Amoongus in the back, I think. I don't know if I want Metagross, actually. This is rough. This is going to be a really hard game to win, I feel like. But I'm going to go Feramosa Amoongus, hoping I can somehow just dish out the damage I need with Feramosa. Maybe play some games with Amoongus. Team doesn't do good against weather. Rain or sun, I've noticed. Let's see. I'll try and face the camera more. Sorry guys, I know I'm facing my TV a lot. All right, so Clefstis. So check this out. Ah, Clef is gonna follow me. That's the super annoying thing. But what we can do, can fake out into that and I think I can go for a max airstream here. Into the Blastoise. Hopefully, it's gonna follow me, but if it doesn't, I'm gonna be so upset.
If you want Japanese snacks, then boy is today's sponsor for
you. Oh boy, I love this. This is great. Boxy. Sorry, I shouldn't say that probably. Gonna get copyright struck. Let me just skip this advertisement. I'm so sorry about that, guys. Next time I have a screen for this shit. Okay. So cool thing here is actually that because of a double protect. Okay, so I get the airstream basically. Airstream is gonna come off. Doesn't do too much to Blastoise, but pretty good amount of damage. Oh, it's a crit. That's nice, that's nice. You gotta love that. Gotta love yourself a good crit. So anyhow, here I think we go for the nice and Volt Switch into storage. And put it to 2. I'd really like to get the fling off. I'm gonna go fling Togekiss and just risk the bisque. Same amount of damage. Gonna be able to boost my speed. Not that it really matters. But yeah, he can't protect again, so. He's probably gonna max, right? He goes for the follow me, so. Cool. That's totally fine. That's what I was worried about. So I'm gonna fling him the lansat berry, which is unfortunate, but it's gonna do a little bit of damage. It's gonna do like no damage. If I'm gonna boost anyone, I'm glad that it was him though. Or her, yeah, the Clefairy. That does a heck ton of damage. It's a crit, yep. It's a crit, beautiful. And then I'm feeling like I'm gonna see either Shell Smash. Yep, Shell Smash comes off here. No problems. As here, I am going to just go for the Volt. I'm gonna double attack into that bad boy. If he follows me, then I don't know. I'll feel bad. I'll feel really, really bad. I'm just gonna continue to max Airstream as it is equally as effective versus him. If we're talking about this versus the max Starfall. Could probably set the Misty Train if he wanted to, but I don't see the point. I don't think he has Yawn or Toxic at this point. Anything weird like that. Yeah, we'll see. He's gonna max his Blastoise, I'm sure. Max is up. It's a big boy, it's a big boy. I think we are max speed on this. We are max speed on this Togekiss, I'm sure of it. It does go for the follow me, so if the Clefairy doesn't die from the Volt Switch, which I think it, ooh, maybe it will. Yes, it does. Okay, cool. So this should do a lot of damage to Blastoise. Let's see. Let's go to Pharaoh. Let's go to Pharamosa. If he goes for the max ice, which he probably will, you have to imagine he's gonna go for the max ice. You get the Airstream up. That looks like a crit to me too. Yep. So Scopal and Super Luck coming in big here. Gonna boost my speed. Goes for the Cannonade. That ends a kiss. Into the Mosa. So Mosa's gonna go down here. From the Cannonade damage, the residual Cannonade damage. However, Togekiss being so fast is really, really nice right now. As here, we can go into the Amoongus to distract. To redirect damage coming into my Togekiss. Out comes the great friend. Oh, what a good friend. What a lovely little friend you have there. That's a fun friend. So here, what we're gonna see happen is the Togekiss is gonna revert back to its normal stage. Here, we're gonna have to go for the Protect into Amoongus. And we can just go for, I think the best bet, oh, that was close. Gosh darn Joy-Con Drift. Yeah, just Air Slash into this Blastoise. Those were the max card, okay. So I have to imagine we're gonna see the Hurricane coming off into the Amoongus here. But if I'm wrong, I'll be very, very upset. Hurricane, yeah, into the Amoongus. Totally fine. Rain Dish. Got the Rain Dish. Okay. He's gonna revert back here, I think. I outspeed his team. Best move here, I think, is going to be going for... Let's see. Oh, he doesn't revert. Okay. So he's got another turn left. I think I'll switch back into the Raichu. God, you can see how bad my Joy-Con Drift is, guys. I'm sorry. And then Togekiss here, really needed to take out the Blastoise. So we're just gonna attack into the Blastoise. He can't double max guard. And if we get the critical hit, I think that will take it out. Decides to withdraw. Okay. Interesting play. Gonna go out into Kingdra. Amun comes back. Out comes Raichu. Can go for the fake out this turn, which is gonna be super consequential, I believe. Hit the crit. No crit there. We get the surf. Spread damage is gonna hurt, but nothing unbelievable. Oh, the cannonade is just super annoying here. I think I got, three airstreams, so I should be able to outspeed. I think I should be able to outspeed the Kingdra. Go for a big Dazzling Gleam. Kingdra goes for the Protect. Pelly? Okay. So Pelly goes down here. Yeah. Critical hit on Pelipper. I'm going to be able to Volt Switch out on the Pelipper and take that out. Cool. That looks good. That's good. Nice thing here is I don't think that Kingdra has a spread move. So we can go Amoongus, and we do have some options. Go on Amoongus, pull this out. Pull this out, baby. No! Oh, cannonade damage. That's so frustrating. Yeah, that cannonade's a big deal, man. Crazy how much that does. That residual cannonade is just so annoying. Okay, so cool thing here is Rage Powder. Actually, no, hold on. This is a rough play here. I think here we have to go. Let's go. Oh, man. Let's go Giga into Stoids. And we'll go fake out into the Kingdra. I really, really hope this works. Okay, that's fine. New music added day. It's actually fine. It's the rain dish. That's fine. I can Oko him with the Volt Switch. One more turn of rain. Oh my god, guys. Check this out. Protect. Done. I think I might be able to get this game. Because you know once this Blastoise goes down, it's 2v1. Or it'll be 1v1, actually. Okay. What do we gotta do here? Does he get Dish still at the end of the turn? Double Protect here is the play for sure to get rid of the rain. Yeah, go for the Hurricane on the Raichu. Interesting play. They're gonna only damage his own Kingdra, so that's fine. I don't think he'll get Rain Dish, because Rain should just end this turn. If I'm correct, yeah. Oh, he just damages his own Kingdra. Pretty good. Rain stops, so no Dish. Okay, cool. So check this out. Fight, we go. Spore into the Kingdra. Oops. We go. This drift, dude. Spore into the Kingdra. And we go. Volt Switch into the Blastoise. Come on, he's gonna protect. He goes for protect. Okay. That's fine. That's actually best. Best case scenario. So now we can take out the Blastoise. Done. Perfect. So yeah, that's gonna cost him. Got the hurricane. Really needs to land one though. Jesus. Swear the Joy-Con. Come on, Switch. Figure this out. This Joy-Con drift is ridiculous. Four in the Kingdra. We'll switch into Kingdra. Oh, and the Volt Switch just takes him out. Wow, that's kind of unexpected on my end, but I'm happy to see it. And yeah, that's a 2-0 so far. It's very, very rare to see the Amoongus Raichu win, but that's how you do it. That's how you do it. All right, we're getting some zinc, guys. Throw me a like for the zinc. Come on, if you watched this far, comment like for the zinc down in the comment section. Like for the zinc. One more battle here, guys. Okay. We're climbing again. We're at 2-1. Are people playing Series 10 right now? Is that something that's going on already? Because I haven't seen it so far, but maybe it's just because most people are still playing in the certain series? Nope, okay. All right. So we got Gyarados. Togekiss is looking quite good here. I am worried about the Rhyperior. Metagross is looking decent as well, actually. Can he follow me? No, okay. Let's go Raichu Metagross. And then in the back, Inteleon is actually really, really good. Wow. And a moon? Or Feralosa or Togekiss? Those are your options, Steven. Yes. Okay, let's go with Togekiss. No. Yeah, let's go with Togekiss. Even on its own, it can be a potent threat with, as you saw, it like crit like 3 straight hits last game. Or the game before last, sorry. Last game was one off of raw skill, guys. Let's be quite frank here. Yeah, sorry if this music isn't your jam. I was just trying it out. I'm not sure it's my jam, but it works. Out comes Gyarados. Alright. He does have Follow Me. Why did I say that? He has Togekiss for Follow Me. That's fine, though. Because what we can do here... Max it up. Max Steel Spike into Kiss. And then we can go... If he... I swear to Gutnitz. Swear to Gutnitz, if he maxes this Togekiss, that's going to be annoying, but... I do see him maxing the Gyarados, if anything, here, and just following me with a Togekiss. This is bulky Metagross, so if he decides to go for Max Dark or Max Ground, I'll be able to take it, get the Weakness Policy, and easily KO this Togekiss. Packing the Ultra Ball. Come on, this has got to be Gyarados, right? I would definitely assume Gyarados here is maxing. Yeah, okay. Whew. Not revealing how bad of a VGC player I am right now. Or player in general. Yes. My Heavy Ball Metagross is going to max. You know, just a little bit fancier. Just throwing that out there. Yeah, it might be shiny too. It happens sometimes. Alright, fake out. So we're gonna easily take out this Togekiss. Obviously, he went for the Max Hailstorm. Wow, interesting play. Does take me out. But yeah, he went for the Follow Me there, so. Glad that I played the way I played here. Gets the Moxie, but the Steel Spike is going to basically negate that. As we see it, it does have the Life Orb. Damn. Kiss out. Kiss out. And now I think what we'll do here is just bring in our own Togekiss. It's max speed, so since he didn't go for the Airstream, I'll be able to outspeed it. And we'll see what he brings in beside his Gyarados. I think since he's packing this Mon, oh my god, this might be really, really good for us, actually. Clear Body, don't have to worry about the Intimidate on Togekiss. Wish I had a competitive Mon here, but that's neither here nor there. Okay, so... I think what we do here... I am gonna go for the Max Quake, I think. I think I'll go Max Quake into Incineroar, and I'll just go... This is tough. If he doesn't... I have to go Air Slash, I think. He woke up sore, unrested, and achy. Sorry, I'm getting a little bit distracted here with the constant commercials. Pillow in the shape of a... So there goes my Togekiss, just right off the bat. Just gonna get the Moxie. Still shouldn't be able to Oko me though. Get the Darkest. Whoa, that does a heck of a ton of damage. Which is just... That blows my mind. Should be able to take an attack from Gyarados still, unless he has the Max Darkness himself. And this will KO the Incineroar. Nope. Oh. Come on, Incineroar. Why are you focus sashed? So aggravating when people do this. Such a joke. Oh yeah, Hail takes it out. Perfect. Thank you, Hail. Hail, your best friend. Alright, out comes the Inteleon. Did we both max turn one? I'm definitely wishing, I think we did. I'm pretty sure his Gyarados and my Metagross max turn one. Out comes Rhyperior. Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god, oh my god. Is this the perfect finish? Check this. Check this. Please, oh please, oh please, oh please. Snapshot. Oko. Oko'd. Straight Oko'd. Done. That's an Oko. Geyser comes off. Is that into Metagross? Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Yes, we live it. We live in it, we live in it. Changes the weather, however. But we're gonna change it back to the hail. Oh yeah, oh that's game, baby. That's game, baby. This is a 3-0. This is a 3-0 episode, baby. Oh, this just goes to show you, man. Never underestimate these Mons, I mean. Obviously, Metagross is just a key in any of the metas these days. Gonna revert back to his normal save. And Inteleon should just snag the KO here. And if not, Metagross will. We'll just go for Ice Punch and Ice Beam for the finish. Life Orb Ice Beam, we'll just take the KO here. Wow, guys, I really hope you enjoyed this series of videos featuring Inteleon and the fling mechanic. The fling, it didn't really get off all that often. When it did, it really, really did some work. But as you can see, Inteleon in the back, waiting for Rhyperior to come in, just absolutely did the work. I really hope you enjoyed this video, guys. Sorry about some of the background music. I'll try and get that panned out for the next time. But in the meantime, I really, really hope you enjoyed this series. And we'll be moving to series 10 here, but like I said, I'm gonna be bringing you a mienshao video. That'll probably be a series 9 video as well. And then we'll bring you some big series 10 heat. I do have some VGC draft league coming up as well. So hopefully you guys enjoy my draft league content. I have done that in the past, kind of strayed away from it because it's very, very time consuming, but I'm gonna be bringing that back to the channel, so. This week I will be battling in a draft league VGC battle. My team features, well, our squad, it's a squad of 12 mons, but I mean, the big key features are things like Calyrex, Shadow Rider, Indeedee. We do have Raichu, Azumarill, Galarian Moltres, all kinds of cool stuff. So please come back and check that out for the 1,000th time. Big ups to you, CloverBells. Thank you for commenting last video. And I will link your video in the channel. You guys gotta check him out. This guy is, he brings some fun people into his videos, and he's a great commentator. So please check out his videos, and hopefully you guys are enjoying the content. Let me know what's next in your minds. In the meantime, this is the Poketechnician signing out for the night. Peace, guys. We'll see you soon.